Rolex handed down for generations.
The House of Onyx has been serving their customers since 1967. They have items for guys and gals of all ages in any price range, starting as low as $20. They don't just sell gifts, they sell memories that can be handed down for generations. At the House of Onyx, you will find jewelry, minerals, fossils, as well as polished, tumbled, and even unearthed crystals. Stop by anytime, Monday through Friday from 9 to 4, no appointment needed. Let Renee and her team help you find your next gift for that special someone that will be enjoyed by generations to come. The House of Onyx, 120 North Main Street, Greenville, Kentucky, 270-338-2363. On behalf of all the hits, Star 107.3 and Mustang Sports Nation, we would like to take this time to thank Double S Farms for all they do for our county, our community, and our student athletes. Wherever a need exists, you will find Double S Farms. Thank you.
All right, Mustang Nation, here we are. Last game, Fort Walton Beach, Florida. We are actually at the high school this time, Fort Walton Beach High School, the quickest drive we've had all week. We're going to be taking on Taylor County with a record of 11-1. Your Mustangs set at 12-3. So it's going to be a good matchup, a good contest. We're going to have to bring it to win today. But we got the man himself, Peyton Carey, on the mound. So that's going to help quite a bit. And we will be back with you. First pitch here in about 5 minutes. All right, here we go. Number 17, Taylor County, steps in the box. We are 2-2 on the week. Played some extremely good teams, and I believe this Taylor County team is going to be probably the best that we face yet. But also, we counter with the best we got, Mr. Peyton Carey, on the mound. So first pitch, I believe an inside ball. Next pitch, a call, strike 1-1 count. Peyton, set. Delivers that one foul back. So 1-2 count, Peyton Carey working ahead. The pitch up and in, spins him out of the way. So an even count, 2 balls, 2 strikes. Peyton Carey set, now throws. Ball hit on the ground, it's gonna be on the right side. Logan Thomas there, we'll take it to first himself and the first out made. And you know what, I don't have any of my stuff up there, so give me just a minute here. Don't have my... I think our Taylor County, what? Oh, two pitches, and I'm on the wrong camera trying to set my stuff up. Give me just a second here. Now we are all set and even. Peyton delivers that ball foul back. The pitch, called strike. That one outside, gonna be a full house. 3-2, full up, Peyton set, now delivers. Nice one, gets him on the strikeout, Peyton Carey. Filling it early, that is a good sign for the Mustangs. So two up, two down, 23. Their third place hitter. He has got baseball written all over him in stature. Stands in the box. Peyton delivers outside. Now the pitch. That one going to be gap right side. Eli DeBoer gets there. He'll get to it. It's on the bounce. Gets it in. Runner now on first. So with two outs, one on. It'll be number 20 for Taylor County. Typically, I can cheat a little bit. Listen to the announcer as they announce them and give you their names, but no announcers today. It is Friday in Florida. I'm sure all announcers are taking the day off. Peyton Carey looks him back, now delivers. Outer portion, didn't get the call. He was wanting that one. Sets 1-0 count, two outs, and he throws. That one fouled off right side. And again, as you can tell, I've had to mount on the nets again, so you will be taken for a ride on every foul ball. The pitch, 1-1 count, foul tip, Colton Carver. Hangs on. And Peyton is up looking down at it now. One ball, two strikes. Batter holds time. Wants to get set against this mighty lefty, Peyton Carey. Runner bluffs. Peyton throws back. Runner trying to get Peyton off the task at hand. Peyton now set with a 1-2 count, and he goes over. Runner showed his hand. He may be thinking about going. And Peyton set. He does go. Colton Carver throws down. A good shot. Skips past him. Carver Rice tried to make a good play. A ball that was cutting toward the base runner. Carver Rice got a glove on it. Knocked down, run down by Cortland Holmes. Carver Rice gets the dust out of his glove. And a 2-2 count. Peyton Carey. Comes set, now throws. Curveball, outer portion, gets him on the strikeout. Atta boy, Peyton Carey. So Mustangs, good inning. Peyton Carey doing what Peyton Carey does. He's seen four, got three of them out, and one runner single. Worked his way on the second. Peyton Carey tightened down the screws, and the Mustangs got out of it. So coming to the plate here is going to be the senior leadoff, Eli DeBoer, number 99. One of nine seniors. We did senior interviews last night. If you get a chance, go back on Facebook, on the 107.3 Facebook page or Mustang Sports Nation on YouTube. You can check those out. Did both girls and boys. Last year I did them together. There was three girls and one boy. And so I did them together, but we had so many this year, had to separate them. So go back and check them out. And Eli DeBoer wants to get it started here for the Mustangs. Eli set as is a pitcher up the middle. Hard hit out of the reach of the shortstop. Eli sees one pitch, gets one hit, takes one base, and puts together one for it by the senior, 099. I tell you what, if you don't know these kids, watching those senior interviews will get you, help you get to know them a little bit. And man, you will certainly gain some respect for 099. Eli DeBoer. Pitch put down, a perfect bunt. That's Carver Rice. Like I said the other day, Carver Rice, productive in every single way, doing whatever it takes to help the team. And he will advance Eli DeBoer. Carver has no problem sacrificing 14, bunted the runner over. And with one out, the senior first baseman, Logan Thomas. He'll play baseball at Brescia next year. Wears number 19, my favorite number. Just a good kid, lefty. Logan up looking down at it. I think it's a 1-0 count, maybe 1-2. That one, a strike. Floated outside, should not have been a strike. Logan does not panic. Looks like a one ball, two strike count. The pitch, Logan goes after it. And the second out will be made. So coming to the plate now, Talon Cartwright. So the runner in scoring position by way of Eli DeBoer. Talon wants to push him across. Watches the first one off speed. In for a strike. A one count. Two outs, bottom of the first inning. Holds up on that one. Ah! That should be non-appealable whenever the umpire is down around second base. He can't see much better than the home plate umpire. Needs to be on first before you can appeal that. Was appealed, he rung him up. I don't believe Talon went, but admittedly, I see everything through a light blue filter. One ball, two strikes. Goes after that one in the dirt. That one's going to try to outrun him. Catcher runs halfway down the line. So Mustangs putting together a little bit of a threat. Eli DeBoer with a good single to start.
Base to mark the time. This field, this game, is a part of our past, Ray. It reminds us of all that once was good, and it could be again. Oh, people will come, Ray. People will most definitely come.
So Peyton Carey reestablishes his spot on the bump. And number one, Taylor County. Steps in. Peyton starts him high. One ball, no strikes. Peyton now set, throws outer portion. A little far off, doesn't get the call. 2-0. The third pitch. Looks good, gets him swinging. That one outer portion, 3-1 count. Nice one there, foul tip. And it's a full house, 3-2. The pitch looks good, hard shot. It's gonna be hit down the left field side. And giving chase is the senior, Maddox Jernigan. He'll find it. Runner will hold on second. And he gets it in, ran in by Carver Rice. All right, a threat applied here by Taylor County. The Cardinals, Peyton Carey gonna white knuckle down, go to work. 15-4 Taylor County, stands in the box. Top of the second inning. The pitch, Colton Carver goes out on a ball a little low. Stays with it, keeps that runner where he's at. 1-0 count, no outs. Peyton set, looks back, showed his hand. We've got a Cardinal that's looking to bunt. So 1-0 count, Taylor in the box, pulls back, strike called, 1-1, way to come at him, Peyton Carey. Set, spins, low. Colton Carver again does a nice job keeping it there. So it's going to be a two ball, one strike count. Top of the third. Batter spins, lays it down. It's going to be foul. Talon will jump on it like a honey badger on a honey bun, making sure that ball doesn't take some type of crazy bounce back fairs. So Peyton Carey has him down in the count, or actually an even count, 2-2. But that will probably remove the bunt. We'll see. Sometimes not, it does. Peyton hits it, doesn't get the call. Woo! Much to the dismay of the Mustang faithful. Full count now, 3-2. Peyton ready, looks back. Now comes set, throws down. And that ball backed up well by Eli DeBoer out in center, and the runner holds. So with a full count, Mustangs taking a breath. And Peyton set. Now he comes. That ball hit a ton. Foul ball actually hits the light on the foul territory. So runner on second base, looking to advance. Mustang's trying to hold him right where he's at. Full count. Peyton goes and rung him up. Should have been rung up three pitches earlier. But it is what it is. Peyton Carey does what he has to do, gets the out. Now, right-handed hitter. It's a little more trouble for our catcher, Colton Carver, because on the throwdown, he's going to have to try to avoid that batter in the right-hand batter's box. Coaches always take this into account. If you call a steal, knowing it's not a straight shot. That ball hit foul. Peyton Carey now up in the count. No balls and a strike. No balls, one strike. Peyton Carey set, now delivers. Beautiful pitch. I'm not exactly sure what that was, but it was a thing of beauty. 0-2 count. Peyton looks back way in the count. Bait pitch up in the zone. Does not go. 1-2 count. Peyton set, looks back at his runner. Colton working to keep him there. That one foul back. The pitch. Oh, what a pitch. Peyton Carey doing what Peyton Carey does. Did you see how much that ball moved? I've got it on a perfect view. I mean, that was a pitch that, honestly, that pitch has been outlawed in seven different states. Luckily, Florida is not one of them. Back in the summer, Peyton, playing for his travel team, was in a state. He forgot. Catcher put down the wrong signal. He threw that pitch, got arrested on the spot. Troy had to go bail him out. But Florida allows it. And we get the strikeout as a result. Here I am running my mouth, not even getting the right outs up there. So two outs now. They started with a runner on second, no outs. Mustangs doing what they do. Now two outs, runner still holds. Peyton Carey on another beautiful shot and a call strike. That was of the fastball variety. The other pitch, very dangerous. A common man can't throw it. Obviously, Peyton Carey can. I've seen Peyton Carey out on the bench. Asked him to try to show me how to throw it. Gave me one, gave me a little instructions. I wound up dropping the ball, punching myself right in the nose. So you got to be of superpower mentality to be able to throw that thing. And another strike, one ball, two strikes. I see now while the Peyton Carey changeup, fastball, slurve, slider, curve, is illegal in 7 states. 1-2 count, 2 outs. That's the only appropriate name for that pitch. Come on, Blue, a little high. 2-2 count.
One more right here, Pete.
Peyton Carey, even up, 2-2. That one's a thing of beauty, center field. Eli DeBoer going to be short in front of him. And the runner will score. First run on the board for Taylor County. So 1-0 Taylor. A runner on first and a lefty in the box. Again, as we was talking about, a possible stolen base from second to third with a runner in the right-handed box. Runner now on first that may be working his way to second. Makes it a little bit tougher on the catcher to see when he takes off. Great first baseman, Mr. Logan Thomas, will alert him. That ball thought was thrown over. Not done. Batter leads off. Or the runner leads off. Batter has to stand put. You know what I'm trying to say. That one a strike. Ooh, spins him around, inner portion. So even count, 1-1. Throws over, keeping that runner close. Mustangs down, 1 run. 1-0 here, top of the second inning. The pitch goes through, nice pitch there. Peyton Carey, 1-2. I guarantee you, Peyton Carey, the calmest individual at the facility right now. The pitch, another beautiful, whatever you call that, slider, change, curve, slurve, it was beautiful.
They have items for guys and gals of all ages in any price range, starting as low as $20. They don't just sell gifts, they sell memories that can be handed down for generations. At the House of Onyx, you will find jewelry, minerals, fossils, as well as polished, tumbled, and even unearthed crystals. Stop by anytime, Monday through Friday from 9 to 4, no appointment needed. Let Renee and her team help you find your next gift for that special someone that will be enjoyed by generations to come. The House of Onyx, 120 North Main Street, Greenville, Kentucky, 270-338-2363. So Mustangs come to the plate. It's going to be the junior Dalton Briggins. So down 1-0, we are bottom of the second inning. Dalton sees that one stay outside. Pitcher rocks, delivers, 2-0 count. Got two lefties battling out on the mound. Taylor County again with a record of 11-1. Mustangs set at 12-3. That pitch a call, strike
Dalton still up looking down at it. 2-1, hitter's count. The pitch, curveball. Two-two count. Cuts through Dalton. Picks a good one to cut at. We'll go down on strikeout. So now the catcher, junior Colton Carver. Goes after the first one, pops it up left side. It's going to be just out of play for the third baseman. So no balls, one strike, Colton Carver going to work. Fouls that one off left side. Same spot over there about where Mr. Troy Carey resides. O-2 count, Colton watches that one. And the second out made by way of strikeout. So Cortland Holmes, another senior. Again, that was interviewed last night. I did senior interviews, both baseball and softball. You can watch those on all the Hit Star 107.3 Facebook page or the Mustang Sports Nation YouTube channel. With two outs, Cortland watches that one stay up and out. One ball, no strikes, two outs. And the pitch. Goes after that one. Going to be a gap shot. Hit high enough for the right fielder to be able to come over and run it down. So the Mustangs will retake the field.
Hit Star 107.3 and Mustang Sports Nation. We would like to take this time to thank Double S Farms for all they do for our county, our community, and our student athletes. Wherever a need exists, you will find Double S Farms.
Mustangs going to the top of the third inning, down one run, 1-0. The Taylor County Cardinals has three hits to the Mustangs one. That hit provided by the leadoff, Mr. Eli DeBoer. And Peyton Carey, a lefty, facing off against a lefty, stands in the box for Taylor County, lays down a bunt. Peyton jumps on it, throws it across, and just in time gets the out. Attaboy, double deuce, Peyton Carey. Again, jumped on that ball like a honey badger on a honey bun. Was not going to let that guy outrun him. Threw it down the first, perfect shot. There on the receiving end, Logan Thomas works for the out. Pitch outer portion, one ball, no strikes. Gets the call on that one, 1-1 count. Another one, same spot. Good speed. The pitch, another one. Three heaters right in the same spot. Peyton Carey sends him back to the dugout on the strikeout. So with two outs, both pitchers dueling, pitching a great game. Peyton Carey in command of all of his good stuff, even the pitch that's, again, been outlawed in seven different states. Peyton impatiently waiting for the batter, saying, come on, let's go. Peyton a fast worker. That ball cut from, looked like to me, cut from the center part of the plate out. It moved that much off the plate. A ball, 1-0 count. That one hit right side. And Cortland Holmes is there for the out. So quite a game being put together here. Both teams, Taylor County, again, enters the contest with a record of 11-1. And your Mustangs set at 12-3. So I believe it's going to be the junior, Maddox Brannon, followed up by the senior, Maddox Jernigan. Two baseball, basketball players here back-to-back. Then we'll roll over to Eli DeBoer. Eli has the only hit thus far for the Mustang. But in my heart of hearts, I feel like that's going to change this inning. So Brannon steps in. Pitcher comes set, now throws. Oh, up and out. Brannon sees it pass. One ball, no strikes. Goes after that one. Outer portion. Good one to cut at. 1-1. Even up. That one stays up. 2-1. Hitter's count. Both pitchers working quick. Maddox goes after that one. Even up, 2-2. The pitch, foul ball. Way to hang, Maddox Brannon. Set, throws that pitch low. Full count, 3-2. Bounce that one back. Way to protect there, Brannon. Still full up, 1-0, Taylor County. We are bottom half of the third inning. Down, he's going to walk him. Nice bit of hitting there, Maddox Brannon, earning the walk. Fought the count full. What's that last one go past? And Maddox Brannon. I put her out. Should have been a runner on. Now we have it corrected. So Maddox Jernan, the senior, 43. That one skips away. Uh-oh, that's going to be a lot of trouble there. So if that ball had made its way in the dugout over there, we would got plus one. Good job by Taylor County to run it down. Terrible job by me to find the right camera. So runner advances without the sacrifice. However, we may push him on around the third. Coach Shelton will deal the hand that's dealt him. So runner on second here, no out. What's Maddox Jernigan gonna do? We shall find out shortly. Yep, staying with the sacrifice. He'll pull back, 2-0 count. I would love for him to work a walk as well and put it on the hot hand, Eli DeBoer. That one up and in, 3-0 count. Moms around the stadium saying, wear it. Easier said than done when you're in a nice cushiony chair over here. That one low, it's gonna skip past. And Brandon will work his way on around to third, Jernigan on first. So a major threat being applied. We're in a really good spot here with the man himself, Eli DeBoer, working his way to the house. So pitcher catcher is gonna talk it over. Eli doing a little housekeeping at the plate. Likes a flat, level ground, doesn't like a mound, front or back. He gets it clean. He'll stand in. Pitcher finds his way to the rubber. Runner's cornered up, and he's going to try first. Jernigan too quick for that. Eli regathers. Pitcher's set. He'll pause, now delivers. Hard shot, left field. He's going to get the run score. So Maddox Brandon, speedster, will come across. That a way to get it done. Eli DeBoer scoring the run. So the run on the board now, tied up 1-1. And Carver Rice, the youngster of the group, stands in. Watches that one stay low. Pitcher having a little bit of trouble here. Tie game 1-1. Bottom of the third inning. Carver goes after that one. Third base gloves. He'll throw down, throw back, 4-2, and he's safe on first. Good hustle there by Carver Rice. Ball gets away for just a minute. They refind it, and Carver puts it in play. Second out made. And the big guy, Logan Thomas. First baseman, I didn't realize the coach is out there talking. I don't even know what he's complaining about. Still arguing his case. I don't know if he's talking about the slide in the second or what, but everything looked clean to me. I'm about as confused as a homeless man on house arrest. I don't know what he's mad about. They're going to talk it over here, umpires.
Hey,
Taylor County coach doesn't get the answer he's looking for. And with a runner on first, by way of Carver Rice, Logan Thomas, the crafty lefty. Hard hitting first baseman. Comes to the plate. Goes after that one. It's going to be hit on the ground to first. Couple players having trouble. And they get there in time. All right. I'm going to take a quick break. So be back. Okay, Peyton Carey back in charge on the mound. That first pitch low will be called a ball. That ball popped up right field. And he outmade. At home, I would have had a camera to show you that, but here, I'm very limited by where I can mount. Peyton, set. Pitch outer portion, didn't get the call. I read something on the comment section of one of my live streams the other day that just made me very happy. That ball hit center field right in front of Eli. It's going to skip past. He will chase. Runner goes to second. He'll hold there. But as I was reading through the comments, I noticed a celebrity has been watching my live streams. Now, back in the old days, the old comedians knew they had made it whenever they would go on Johnny Carson, and Johnny Carson would give them the nod after a set. In our world, you're kind of measured by the celebrities that watch your live stream. So we've got a lot of celebrities, as you know, around Muhlenberg County. Everywhere from the pitch inside, call the ball. Everybody from Warren Oates to the Everly Brothers to Merle Travis, Patrick Sparks, Jade Perry, we've got a lot of them, but this guy is above all of that. And I found out the other day that he enjoys watching the live stream. So that ball hit Cortland Holmes, makes the catch for the second out. So when I read that, I thought, man, maybe I'm doing something right. Maybe I have made it. The young man's name is Trader Chapman. If you guys know him, you know what kind of celebrity he is. One of the biggest Mustang fans out there, Mr. Strader. has been tuning into my live stream, so we are certainly glad to have you. I hope you're getting a chance to watch this one, but I know with all the autograph sessions you're having to sign and all the important work you're doing, you may not get a chance to today, but hopefully this will find its way back to you. Oh, balls, one strike, two outs here, Peyton Carey. Up in the count, still two outs. That one outside. One count. The catcher, Colton Carver, wants to go out. Discuss things with his pitcher. Peyton concurs. And we are reset with a one ball, one strike count. Outside, doesn't get the call. 2-1. Peyton. Steps back. Gonna regather himself. Felt he should have got that call, as did I. 2-1. Good. That one he does get, hit on the ground. Just foul, Talon Cartwright. We'll gather it up. Two strikes, two outs. Top of four, Peyton Carey. Slices, does not stay. Peyton walks off the mound. The whole world, everybody except for the umpire, thought that was a third strike. Peyton doesn't get it. It was a slicer. That was his pitch. I think the umpire possibly didn't see it. He was as confused as a mosquito in a mannequin factory and just guessed that it was a ball. 3-2 is the call. That one, surely you'll call. He does, and that's a third out. Way to get it done, Peyton Carey. My radar, this net just jacks it all up, yeah? All right, the junior, number 14, third baseman, Talon Cartwright comes to the plate. Tie game, 1-1 Talon.
Let's go, 1-4.
Cuts after the first one. No balls and a strike. Talon resets, awaits that pitch low and out. 1-1 count.
Let's
Now the pitch fouls that one back. One ball, two strikes. Talon leaves that one out. If the umpire had called that one, Mustang Nation in the stands would have probably rioted here in Fort Walton Beach. 2-2 count. That is the pitch that Peyton has not been getting. That one fouled back. Hang on to your shorts. You're going to go for a little bit of a ride there. Two-two count, Talon. Hits that one, it's gonna be hit hard up the middle, get through, it does. So Talon Cartwright staying with it. And we'll earn the second hit of the game. And Dalton Briggins will attempt to push him along. I love the game within the game. Coach Shelton says, hold on. No need for there to be a chance you miss my call. I'm going to tell you in your ear hole just to make sure there's no mistake. Gives him the command. Dalton steps back at it. The pitch thrown over. Talon finds his way back. That pitch a ball, 1-0 count. Delivers inside. Rocks Dalton back off the plate. But the umpire seemed to like it here. 1-1 count. That one fouled back. One ball, two strikes. Pitch goes after it, a shot! It's gonna be down in front of left field. And with no outs, Mustangs putting together a threat. So Colton Carver. Comes to the plate with a chance to do some damage here. Mustangs on first and second. We're gonna see if coach lets the hard hitting catcher swing away or if he's gonna sacrifice, he'll go the sacrifice. In a low scoring game, we're gonna take every run earned and unearned for that matter. 0-1 count. For mute. Golden spins, lays it down, a beautiful bunt. Pitcher gloves, throws across, and Colton Carver will get it done. So the first out made, runners now second and third. Colton Carver, solid in every respect. At the plate, behind the plate, as he's the catcher. On the base pass, in the dugout, quite an influence. If you're a fan of baseball, you are a fan of him. And now, senior Cortland Holmes. That one up. One One ball, no strikes, one out, runner second and third. We are bottom of the fourth. The pitch. Cortland sees one he likes, goes after it. That will even the count. 1-1. Stays low, two balls and a strike. Cortland on it. He's going to be a play at the plate. He's in there. Nice job here. Talon Cartwright hustling hard, makes his way to the box. And the Mustangs will go on top now, 2-1. A little late on trying to get the dugout celebration here, but the Mustangs will take the lead. So let's see here. Got runners on a corner. I will give Mustangs that run here in just a minute. Nope, I'll do it right now. Hard earned. Mustangs up 2-1. Runners on the corner and a bunt. Foul back. Maddox Rannon getting instructions from the general, Coach Shelton. Cortland Holmes with wheels on first. Could steal at any moment. Spins, lays it down, another good one. He's gonna go to first. Cortland Holmes will make his way to second. Second out made, and runners now on second and third. All right, so the speedy senior, Maddox Jernigan. I tell you what, nice job by these boys getting their bunts now.
Step off just a little.
So the senior, Maddox Jernigan. First one to call strike. In a big spot here, Mustangs up 2-1. Leaves that one high. 1-1 count. Off left side, it's going to be back on the football field. Hits a tackle in the head. Luckily he had his helmet on. One ball, two strikes. Call the third strike, outer portion. Tough call. But the Mustangs take the lead. On a great inning.
Pate and Carey. First one, a strike, 0-1 count. Pate with the pitch, nice one.
Oh!
He's not giving him anything on the strike, the black stripe of the plate. 1-1 count. That one low, two balls and a strike.
Keep working, Tess. You got this. Be ready, defense. More effective.
Outer portion in, 3-1. Peyton with the pitch, nice one.
Nice.
Pull up now, 3-2. Way to fight your way back here, double deuce. Ball hit on the ground, Talon tries to reach for it, just passed him. So runner will reach for Taylor County. Say this top,
number one,
bottom of the lineup. Number nine hitter, number five for Taylor County. So we are top of the fifth inning. Spins, thinks about a bunt. Runner retreats. Bunt not made. Tying run on first for Taylor County. Peyton Carey plans to leave him there. That ball hit back to Peyton. He's going to rock, throw to first, get the out. And 17 comes to the plate. And everybody's hollering for Wyatt. Hope it's not wide herb. We don't need nobody to get shot. All right, apparently it's Wyatt, number 18, coming in to pinch run. So top of the lineup, number 17, I believe it is. Wears the number of Shohei Ohtani. If that means anything to you, it certainly does to me, as I'm a Dodger fan. No haters, please. Out, that ball bounces away. Colton Carver gets on it quickly, though. Good job there. Little things turn big at the end of the game. That one may loom very important as the runner has to stay. Umpire now, kicking the dirt, doing a little house cleaning. Peyton Carey on the pitch. Ball hit on the ground, too short. Carver rides, gloves, throws. And I don't know what the call was. Apparently he was there, safe. Umpire was, or in my view of the umpire, that made the call was blocked. So no outs, runners first and second. Actually one out, sorry. Runners first and second for the Cardinals of Taylor County. Mustangs ahead here in the top of the fifth, 2-1. strike, Peyton. Bunt laid down. And it's a bunt attempted. Popped straight up, Colton Carver. Jumped on it. Ball spun backwards, stayed in foul territory. If that ball would have been a foot further, we would have been in good shape. Colton could have threw it to third, and then Talon Cartwright would have had options. He could have went to second or first. As is, 0-2 count, one out. Outside now, 2-2. Actually, 1-2, sorry. One ball, two strikes. Here we go, Peyton. That ball hit straight away center field. Eli DeBoer on it for the second out. Big play by the speedster out there. Roaming that center field territory. So have I mentioned this beautiful Florida weather? I was scared to death this morning when I asked Alexa here in Florida what the weather was. She told me the weather back in Kentucky, I about had a heart attack. 34 degrees, but here, as soon as I got it corrected, she let me know it was in the 60s. So not to rub it in or anything, but kind of to rub it in. That one, not a call strike, should have been a call strike. Steps back. Runners first and second. Peyton asked for Colton to come out. Let's talk this over here. And Coach Brody says, all right, I'm going to triple check to make sure we're all on the same page. Coach Brody realigns the guys, gets their minds set, pointed in the right direction. Colton Carver will find his way back behind the house. Peyton Carey finds his way back on the ball. Runners will find their way back off the base. Peyton looks back to second, comes set, pitching from the stretch, and now throws. That one fouled off right side. So a one ball, one strike count. So again, we are at the ninth of the 10 games that I'm going to do here in Florida. And the girls will play later today at 1 o'clock. So please tune in. Luckily, there's plenty of time between this one and that one. We don't have to race over there. Peyton Carey. That one. Ooh, almost gets a piece of the on deck. And Peyton trying to get this last strike and get his team back in the dugout.
Hey, deep breath.
Peyton sets, now throws. Boy, Peyton Carey, the Mustang faithful will meet him in celebration. Way to work, Peyton Carey.
On behalf of all the hits, Star 107.3 and Mustang Sports Nation, we would like to take this time to thank Double S Farms for all they do for our county, our community, and our student athletes. Wherever a need exists, you will find Double S Farms.
All right. So Mustangs in another good spot here. Eli DeBoer, the fabulous senior, 99. Great kid, great ball player. Steps in a box. Goes after that one, hit back to the pitcher. He's gonna glove throw across. Try to stay up the middle, hit it. Too middly, if you will, right to the pitcher. So with one out, Talon Cartwright. Pops that one right side, first baseman. Gives chase out of play. And an 0-1 count with one out here, bottom of five. So 1-1. Goes after it inside. 1-2. Now the pitch, outside. Two-two count. Goes after, wow, hits it right in the dugout. Sends the Taylor County baseball team scurrying like roaches in the sunlight. That was something. Glad they're okay. 2-2 count still. Another one fouled right side. First baseman gives chase still just out of his reach. Still even count. 2-2. One out. The pitch. Fouled off left side. Two balls, two strikes, the pitch. Stays up, good job here. Carver Rice working it full. Carver Rice, the pride of Jackie and Jeff Kirby, with a full count looking at him, leaves it out, atta boy, Carver Rice. And that puts it on the hook. Lefty Logan Thomas. Carver Rice awaits an opportunity to try to advance. Logan Thomas hoping to give it. Goes after it. That ball hit left side. Out of play. Throws back, Carver Rice, the ball skips away, here we go. Carver Rice, that young kid just makes stuff happen, you know, that's what you gotta say about Carver Rice. Where there's a will, there's a way, and he finds it. And now he finds his way on down to second base in scoring position. And that may change the at-bat here for Logan Thomas. No balls and a strike. Hard shot right to the shortstop, Carver Rice. Back, and apparently a double play turn. Couldn't find the right camera to give you guys the angle. I should have left it right there. Don't know if he got him or not. Umpire says yes. And the Mustangs will go to the top of the sixth inning, up still 2-1.
Has been serving their customers since 1967. They have items for guys and gals of all ages in any price range, starting as low as $20. They don't just sell gifts, they sell memories that can be handed down for generations.
At the House of Onyx, you will find jewelry, minerals, fossils, as well as polished, tumbled, and even unearthed crystals. Stop by anytime, Monday through Friday from 9 to 4, no appointment needed. Let Renee and her team help you find your next gift for that special someone that will be enjoyed by generations to come. The House of Onyx, 120 North Main Street, Greenville, Kentucky, 270-338-2363.
So we are top of the six, Taylor County number 20. Will find his way to the box. Peyton Carey. Will take his place on the bump. Looks at Colton, comes set, throws, nice one for a call strike. Second pitch, another one, strike, 0-2 count. Peyton Carey always works extremely fast. He is an absolute joy to watch. If you've never had a chance, you need to come out and watch his team regardless of who's pitching. But Peyton Carey can bring it. That one hit right side. Logan Thomas will gather it up. The pitch, slicer, dicer, that is that ugly pitch from a hitting standpoint. Beautiful if you're a pitcher. The slicing curve, fastball, changeup, knuckling curve. The only thing I know to call it. And the batter, uh-oh, y'all watch out. We may get a pitch up here in the net. Peyton doesn't like it when they call timeout and back out on him. Yep, kind of felt that one. I love the game within the game. Peyton says, do not do that again. And the pitch, and another timeout. And now. And now the umpire goes out and says, by chance, did you just fly by my tower? The old flyby in Top Gun. Peyton says, quit calling timeout, and I promise it won't happen again. So now Peyton Carey with the pitch. And that one out. So 2-2 count, or is it a 1-2 count? No, 2-2. Peyton, low, And that'll drive it full 3-2.
Hey, glove and hand, you're good. Let's go.
Peyton with a full count and the pitch. Beautiful shot! And my man Peyton wins the battle. So the Mustang faithful cheering mightily. The Taylor faithful as quiet as, so quiet you can hear a mouse pee on a cotton ball. But right now, Peyton Carey, a little low and inside. One ball and no strike. That one fouled off right side. That one hit right side, right fielder. Made a good attempt on it. Ran down by Eli DeBoer and gets it in. Heck of an attempt by Dalton Briggins. And a runner will reach with one out. Cuts through, good strike. One out, runner on second. We are top of the sixth inning. Curveball inside. This is my first base camera. I don't know if I got somebody over there trying to make hand puppets or what. 1-1 count. Pitch, Peyton, outer portion, a call strike, 1-2. Spins. I always love it. Anytime a kid spins, they scream and balk. Peyton Carey hit on the ground, first base. It is fair. It'll get through, and a run will score here to tie the game for Taylor County. So 2-2, tie game. And a runner now on first. And a new batter steps in, number 35, a big one. A pitch, a ball, 1-0 count. And Coach Shelton says, hold tight. Let's talk this over here. One ball, no strike, still one out. Want to leave that runner on first. And it's going to be a pitching swap. back at it. I think one of those knuckleheads, the opposing team, waiting for the game to come up, shut my camera off on first. All right, two balls and a strike. And now pitching is Maddox Brannon. Maddox with a 2-1 count. The pitch. Now 3-1. And there it is. Full house now. Good shot there, Maddox Brannon. Comes set, now throws. That ball hit in the gap. Eli DeBoer will try to run it down, trying to get there before this runner plates, and he's going to send him, is the coach, and Taylor County will go up 3-2 on a good hit there by the pinch hitter. Taylor County having to retake the lead, or taking the lead now, 3-2. We are still top of the sixth inning. One out. Curveball up and in, 1-0 count. Set. Now throws. Nice one. That one popped up straight away. It's going to be a shortstop. Trying to find it myself. And a nice play made there by Carver Rice. So two outs now. Mustangs trying to find their way back in the dugout to put together an inning. And number five for Taylor County. Steps in the box. Maddox Brannon looks back to second base. Now throws. Pitch on the outer portion, fouled off. 0-1 count. Curveball stays up. So a one ball, one strike count, Maddox Brannon. Nice one, gets the call, 1-2. Maddox ready to end it. Gets that ball hit on the ground, second base. Good glove on a tough hop. There on the receiving end, Logan Thomas. Yeah. Right here among us.
Hey, how'd the interview go?
Went good. Went good. They all did good.
My son said anything stupid.
No, no.
I told him beforehand, I was like, any question you're asked, your answer should be my mother.
That's right.
My mother.
Who threw you the most pitches in batting practice? My mother.
Come on, Scoot.
All right. Talon Courtright. We'll step in the box. Mustang down in a tight one here, 3-2. Hard shot. That ball's hit a ton. Come on, ball. It's out of here. Woo! How about it? Talon Courtright taking matters into his own hand. Man, what a shot by the junior tying this ball game. I'll tell you what, attaboy 14. That is what happiness is made of, right there. Talon Courtright ties the game. Here I am, sitting here with a grin on my face, not even giving him credit with the run. Now we're even up. Man, that was not a fence scraper. It was a shot. Talon Courtright, man. How fun is that? Hard shot. Up over the shortstop. And Dalton Brigham's now going to reach. So when you wonder what this team is made of, they will gladly show you. So runner on first, tie game, no outs. So the catcher, the mighty Colton Carver, with a chance to do more damage. Looks at a bunt. Runner hung up, gonna throw down. Mistake by the catcher. Great bit of base running there by Dalton Brigham. In that instance right there, he always, as a catcher, wanna run at the runner. Make him commit one way or another, but you don't wanna make that long throw. Because as you've seen there, Dalton had a chance to make it back. Colton pulls back. Ah! On a pitch. Should have been called outside. That pitch too far out. 1-2. Talon Courtright with his second home run of the year. Ball hit on the ground first. Gonna be, oh, he's there. But not called. Close one. So with the first out, runner on first. And Colton Carver will get a pinch runner. It is going to be the Luke Harden.
Come on, Court. Nobody better than it. Base hit, Court. Moving around. Come on now.
pitch outside. Good eye here by Cortland Holmes. Nope, just one. One ball, no strikes, Cortland. Sees that one go in for a strike. Going to first, back in there is Luke Harden. Pitch cuts through, one ball, two strike count. Cortland down looking up at it, trying to work the count back even or find something he can hit. The pitch fouls it off. 3-3 game, bottom of the sixth inning. Cut ball outside, stays away. Luke Harden takes an extra step. Cortland Holmes likes that one. He's going to go center field. Going to be a little trouble. It's down. And Luke Harden will find his way down to second. Cortland Holmes with the hit. And a little bit of pressure being applied here by your Mustangs. Runners first and second, only one out. And the pitcher of record, Mr. Maddox Brannon. We'll look down to the general, Coach Shelton. Coach reminding, coaching, explaining what needs to be done in any given circumstance here. Maddox Brannon. Pitch up. 1-0 count. A good pitch and a good pitch to swing at. Maddox Brannon went after it. 1-1 count is the result. I can feel the tension both sides of the field here. That pitch inside, all speed pitch, 1-2 count. Maddox Brannon will reset. Set, throws, goes after it, fouls it back. So he's hanging tight, 1-2. Again, two on, Cortland Holmes, the runner on first. Luke Harden, the pinch runner for Colton Carver. Stands in on second, and at the box is Maddox Brannon. The pitch, that one low, working his way back here. 2-2 count, even up. Pitch, Maddox goes after it, fouls it back. Three to three the score, bottom of the sixth inning, 2-2 count, Maddox Brannon. Watches that one stay out, full count. Great eye there by the junior, number 44. Full up. Goes after. Patriot, a fastball up in the zone for the second out. Good at bat there, Maddox Brandon. But he goes down on the strikeout. So Maddox Jernigan, senior 43. Extreme wheels here, anything close, or he can make anything close. So Maddox on deck, looming is the senior Eli DeBoer. That pitch up, man, I would love to see Eli get a chance with the bases loaded here. One old count and two outs, bottom of six, the pitch. Goes after it, that'll even it, 2-2. The pitch, thinks about a bunt, pulls back, shows what his wheels can do. Catcher pitcher has to take note. Two-one count, Maddox up looking down at it. Pitcher set, looks back to second, now delivers. That's going to be wide. We are one ball away from giving Eli a chance with the bases loaded. So 3-1 count, he may watch one here, we shall see. Nope, goes after it and a good one to go at. He's a hitter, wants to hit. Don't blame him a bit, but the count will reach full, 3-2. Maddox awaits. That one a call, third strike. But Talon Cartwright ties the game on a long home run. I am back with you. Clear my runners, clear my outs. 3-3 the score. We're going to the top of the seventh inning. Mustang's going to try to hold, and then we'll be in good spot. Going to our leadoff guy, Maddox Brandon, or Eli DeBoer, but Maddox Brandon starts out with a ball on the bump. 1-0 count. So if we had one spot to pick where we wanted to start going into the bottom of the seventh inning, that's where we'll be. Eli DeBoer, the speedster, hard hitting center field. Maddox goes after that one. That ball is going to be popped left field. And there to make the play is the senior Maddox Brandon. Again, hard for me to get those outfield shots when I'm away from home. So one out and number seven. We'll start it out for Taylor. Cuts that one inside. And a ball, 1-0 count. Call strike, 1-1. Two-one count. That ball foul back. So I'm fixing to go over there and take care of this. Somebody's messing with my camera. So hold tight. All right, I'm back with you. I'm willing to predict we don't have that problem again. So what happened there? Walk. So runner on first. And two outs. So a runner on, Maddox Brannon. Comes set, now throws. It's up there. The pitch. Maddox Brannon, the pitch, a little out, 3-0 count. Maddox trying to work through it here. The pitch, nice one, there we go, 3-1 count. Now Another one. Gets him swinging. Way to fight back here, Maddox Brannon. So full count, runner on first, top of the seventh inning. Runner takes off, that one's up. Didn't get the call. And Coach Shelton, we're gonna take a quick break. Team there to greet Maddox for great effort. So Austin Rowe will come in to try to finish off here in the second. So Austin Rowe now on the bump. Runners first and second, two outs. Austin Rowe looks back. Now comes set, throws, that's a strike.
I filled up here, 12, let's go.
All right. Having to try to charge my iPad. Give me just a second. And we got a charge. Thank you. Austin. Set, throws that pitch inside. Good job by the catcher, Colton Carver. Making sure, absolute sure, that ball stays right there and the runners do not advance. Don't need them working their way on to third if we can keep from it. Austin with a 1-1 count, looks back, now delivers. That one stays up. Colton Carver throws down. Makes it close. Heck of a shot there by the catcher. Colton Carver. Two balls, one strike, two outs, Austin. Nice one, foul back. That'll even it up, 2-2. Austin ready. Delivers. Knocked down. Check it. Yeah, there we go. So full count. Mustangs on the ropes just a little bit here. Runners first and second, still two outs. Austin Rowe in charge. He'll turn, throw! Up a little bit. Bases full of Cardinals. With two out. So sometimes when I have to charge my iPad, there's a little bit of interference. You may hear a little bit of a roar. Hope that's not the case. But if it is, got to charge right now. That ball up and out. One ball, no strikes. The pitch, another one up and out, 2-0 count. Alston trying to work through it here. Count. Veteran Logan Thomas comes over and wants to talk to his pitcher. Austin with great defense behind him. Wants to find a bat. And that one up. 3-0 count. It's a little bit of a predicament. Well, more than a little bit here. 3-0 count. No place to put him. Runners first, second, and third. Two outs. Top of seven. Austin going to have to white knuckle down. Find a strike. And that one's up. Just having a tough time getting a grip on it. So a run will play for the Cardinals. So 4-3, the score. Base is still loaded. And the coach. For Taylor County, wanting to talk to his hitter. Number three will be in the box. Hits from the right side. Bases loaded, pressure applied always. When that is the case, to the catcher, to the pitcher. Got to make sure no pass ball, wild pitches are committed. And a strike thrown, attaboy Austin. So ahead now, a one count. Stays up. Every time he's missed, Austin's been missing high. 1-1 count. So a great talent right here, Austin Rowe, one of the many seniors. Where's number 12? Throws, that's a good one. Foul tip, held on. Not that that matters on the second strike by Colton Carver. It would have had it been the third strike. So Colton just getting a little practice in. It's actually something you can't practice. Austin. Set 1-2 count, the pitch. Down low, good job, Colton. As we mentioned, making sure that ball doesn't get past. So with a 2-2 count and two outs, twos all across. The top of the board. Austin Rowe delivers. Nice one! On the strikeout. Way to get out of it, young man. Austin Rowe.
And Daddy.
So Mustang still in a good spot here. We are going to be going to the top of the lineup. The great in every way, Eli DeBoer, number 99 senior. Man of faith, man of conviction. And a man who is ready to get on right here. Bottom of the seventh inning. Eli DeBoer will start it here for the Mustangs. No other place would we rather be in the lineup than starting out with the leadoff. Eli DeBoer, he goes after the first one, fouls it back, a 1 count. That ball down, 1-1 count. So even up, Eli awaits. That one stays up with his wheels. He is a triple threat, a five-tool player. That one fouled off. It is going to work its way fair. Foul, sorry. Got my F's wrong. Fair foul. That's why in the umpiring world, whenever a ball's hit fair or foul, they don't say to ever scream fair. It's always foul and point in the direction it goes so as to not confuse the players. So 2-2 count. Eli goes after that one and a strikeout. So Carver Rice now. Will step in. Carver Rice, Mr. Production. Watches that one stay out. Worked a walk his last at bat. Would love to do that or get a hit or hit one out or any combination of. Right now, 2-0 count. Logan Thomas on deck. That went up, 3-0 count. Nice work here by the youngster sophomore, Carver Rice. Fakes a bunt, pulls back, messes with the pitcher, and it works as he will earn his way off. I told you, he is Mr. Production. Just a sophomore. We're going to get to see him for two more years past this one. And the coach for Taylor County wants to go out. Talk it over. So a pitching change will be had for Taylor County. Yep.
baseball has marked the time.
All right, Logan Thomas, senior first baseman. We'll stand in. No balls, one strike. Logan resets. Cutter outside, 0-2. Logan will step out. That pitch outside, one ball, two strikes. Hard shot, right side, it's gonna be pulled foul, but Logan saw it well. So one ball, two strikes, Logan Thomas goes after it. A nice pitch there by the Cardinals, so Mustangs down two. The last chance here. The big hitter already having hit a home run in this game. Talon Cartwright. So Talon with Carver Rice waiting on first. Comes set. Goes after it. Hits on the ground to shorty. Backhands. Throws it across, and the out will be made. So the Mustangs go down in a close one here in Fort Lauderdale. Two good teams battling it out. Taylor County will leave with the win as the Mustangs go down by a score of 4-3. So the softball team will play today at 1 o'clock. Please tune in for that one. I will be there after that game. We are going to pack up and head back to Kentucky. So this game was brought to you by All the Hits, Star 107.3. And on behalf of Casey, Michael Davis, and myself, we thank you for tuning in. And may God bless you wherever you are.